It's a glorious Friday. Welcome back to the Welcome to Corris. Me and Chris are here at Corris celebrating a very special occasion.
Certainly are.
We are. Go on then. You can let them know.
Spill the beans. Right. Well, having built this fantastic locomotive from scratch, which is a Kerr Stewart tattoo, the same as Edward Thomas on the Talyllyn. Having built this, they've surpassed that and built another one. So there is the brand new Falcon, built by Alan Keefs, that the Corris have had built and raised a considerable sum of money for over the years to build it. It's a sparkling little performer. It's very impressive that it's all happened at all. The TR supported it in some small ways, just by providing drawings. And, they come over to visit and looked all over the Falcon that we've got. We provided the air pump and we made the two injectors for it. And we've always tried to help the Corris as much as we can, because we're doing the same thing in the same area. So why wouldn't you? They're a fantastic bunch of people, and it's nice to sort of dip into their celebration today and sort of share some of their excitement. It's brilliant.
Yeah. I was going to say, it's been something like 15 years in the making, this, isn't it?
I think so, yeah.
It's been a long time, and they've raised money from their membership, and you know, the appeal's been running that long, and they've finally been able to put it all together and get it running, and
they've had the determination to go through to the end.
They were, I think it was delivered Wednesday, wasn't it? And they've been trialling it up and down until now, when they're finally ready to release it to the public tomorrow, isn't it?
That's it. So it's going very well. Alan Keefs have built it, and Patrick Keefe is here for the day. There's a lot of invited important people. Not saying we're important.
No, not us. We just turned up.
But it's a red hot sunny day. Everything's going well. The engine's in brilliant condition. The old pump's clanking away there, pumping the air up.
And it's slightly different, isn't it, to the one we've got? Isn't the cab the original shape and slightly bigger?
The cab's slightly taller, but it's the same style as the original cab.
Ah, that's
it. So ours was altered a lot by John Bate in the 60s, I think, or 70s, to be a lot smaller. But this is much bigger in area, and it's quite nice to work in, I would imagine.
Yeah, it is. It feels really airy inside, but it's got a lot of the valves that are outside on ours inside, hasn't it?
That's true.
Yeah. So there's a lot more going on in there, and it's toasty.
Yeah. She's been on it.
I've been on it. Yeah. I was lucky.
The other nice thing is it looks authentic. When you see it in the setting with the old engine shed or the mountains behind the Corris coaches, it looks like one of those old black and white pictures in Martin Fuller's book. You know, it just looks the part. I think we're really impressed. I think they've done really well.
Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful quality craftsmanship on it, isn't it?
Hi Chris.
Hi Jack, all right. How are you doing?
Yeah, thank you.
Good, eh?
What are you doing here?
Exactly, I'm at work, believe it or not, and you're volunteering on the Corris, as you've done for many years, and you also volunteers on the Talyllyn. So there's a lot of crossover with all of our people.
Yeah, bit of an alliance going on, is there, really?
Yeah, you've got to work together. There's no problem.
Where were you yesterday working?
I was working on this.
You were helping us here, weren't
changing
you?
Changing an air pump and delving into it to try and make it work.
We got there in the end.
Proof's
in the pudding, isn't it, really?
You just heard the pump working.
Yeah.
So that's fine. So reason really is to tell everyone, why is it here? Why didn't you just get another steam engine from somewhere else? Would that have been cheaper?
Yeah, well, obviously when the rail was shut in 1948, both engines went to the Talyllyn after a couple of years sat at Machynlleth. So obviously we couldn't buy them back for 50 quid for the pair. So 1996, the society, well, before I was born actually, set up the tattoo loco fund for that engine over there, number 7. That was in service by 2005.
Brilliant.
And then after that, they thought, well, actually, we've done a good job of that one. We managed to deliver it, so why don't we have one of each,
Brilliant.
The Falcon and a tattoo. So obviously the tattoo was the simplest one, based on number 4, much more modern 1920s engine. This one, the design originates mid-1870s, 1878, the first one was built.
Loughborough.
What would be the most recently the brushworks. So they decided, I think it was 2006 it was, that we were going to build this, and 18 years or so later, we've got it.
Fantastic.
And it's quite nice, actually. There was one of our volunteers, Peter Guest. You'll see his name on the back of the headboard there.
Yep.
Sadly passed away a few weeks ago. Him and his wife, Rosie, who's here today.
They were
behind fundraising for both the engines, so it's quite nice that they're both in service today, and we've got a lot a lot of thanks to all them, really. But yeah, I think it was just the dream, really. They were rebuilding the railway from the late 60s, and then it got to the point in the 90s. They thought, well, we'll be running diesel in 2001, 2002. It would be nice to have a steam engine, not have to borrow one from the Talyllyn. I think when number four came in 1994, made people realise it would be quite nice to have a proper steam engine and have a fleet here. And
well, I think they've done exactly the right thing. It belongs to you. There's no hire fees or engine owning groups or anything like that. Yeah. It's brand new. It's going to last as long as it's looked after.
It's £1,000 a day to hire a Talyllyn one, isn't it? Wasn't it? It's when you were in charge, it is, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah.
Yeah. So, yes.
Yeah, should we have a look round the engine?
Yeah, what do you want to look in the cabin
Just
first?
See the differences, really, between this and to Hayden on the TR.
Yeah, so obviously the cab's a lot different. The cab's as it should be. So when three was built, well, one, two and three were built, they had a cab like this. Obviously it was a bit lower, because back then the coaches were lower as well.
Little Welshman too.
Little Welshman. I'm a tall Welshman, I am. But the cab, I think it was about 2.5 inches lower. Yeah. But obviously since the carriages have had new bogies and they've got new underframes, that's what they've naturally gone up in height. Right. So that's why three on the Talyllyn looks quite dwarfed by the coaches, because it is the original height. So we thought rather than make it look like three, we'd make it look like three did when it was here, and have all the roofs, because you see there, the roof of the engine is perfect with the roof of the carriage as well. Yeah. We've also raised the chimney a couple of inches as well, just to compensate.
Oh, it doesn't show.
It doesn't show, does it? But it's been done really sympathetically. So
that's good.
You've got this nice, quite open cab. It'd be a bit toasty, I think, in the summer, as it is today, because you've got all the firebox in here, but everything's quite
not
accessible.
Too bad. At least the wind can get through.
Yeah.
So the front window's open.
The front window's open. These are an exact copy of the original ones on number three.
Yeah. So one change is the air brake, isn't it? You've got an air brake cylinder.
Yes, so these are the brakes.
Compressed air puts the brake on the engine.
Obviously we've got the air pump, as we were talking about earlier, you've got the air brake cylinders here, which is probably where your vacuum gear would have been years ago.
Oh,
I think some of it was under the floor on the fireman's side, possibly.
So they originally had a massive vacuum cylinder, didn't they?
Massive, yeah.
And vacuum cylinders have to be big because of the low amount of force that you have.
Absolutely,
So an air cylinder can be a lot smaller, so it's easier to find space.
So we've got these air cylinders here, obviously. The steam air pump is your air compressor. Fills these up, and then you've got your air brake. So it's got, that's your engine brake. And then you've got your train brake there. So when we're going along, the carriages slow us down. Rather than the engine slow the carriages down, same system as the Talyllyn, single pipe air, works very well. Obviously we've got a lot of this on number three is outside the cab, like the regulator rod going into the dome, but it's quite weird actually, because everything that's in here on number three, the cab ends here. So it is a little bit weird actually being on it and having all the controls in here.
Well, it's
it's quite nice in a way, and it actually, I think it's shown that, you know, three was obviously modified to make it more ergonomic, but I think with a little bit of thought, this has become just as ergonomic and in keeping with its heritage as well, really. You can see how much coal you've got left, which is quite nice. We were worried about how easy it would be to coal it and things like that, so we've got this little hatch here. So this, you wouldn't see this from the outside, but you take these pins out and the whole side of the cab flips open. And you can move that little shelf where my bag is, and you can just pop the bags of coal in there. Which is quite similar to what number three's got, actually, because it's got that little door, hasn't it?
Yeah.
But actually, it just shows you can keep the original profiles of the engine, or the correct...
That's quite neat, isn't it?
Hughes Falcon profile of the engine, and make it as easy as you can for the user, which is nice.
It is, right?
Modern.
Brilliant.
Obviously, more modern pressure gauges, that sort of thing, because
valves are different, aren't they, from the TR?
Yeah, these are just off the shelf.
That's the same, and that controls the air pump.
That's the air pump.
That starts the air pump running when the air pressure goes down, doesn't it?
So when there's a demand for air, it'll make the pump kick in.
Same type of drive brake valve.
Yeah, so regulator's the same.
Yeah, Talyllyn injectors, brand new Talyllyn injectors. Yeah.
What else have we got? We've got a little, this is quite tidy here actually, so. Number three's blowdown valve is outside on the fireman's side. So here we've got this little hatch when it's all hidden under there. So that's the blowdown valve. Obviously you've got access there then to your mud hole door to wash it out. But on three, that's all exposed, and obviously that blowdown valve's on the side. So it's actually a bit easier for the user probably. You don't have to make sure the rods are in the right place to access it, 'cause it's just under your feet. Got the damper as well. Is quite nice there. Put air through the bottom of the fire, and it just sits there nice and tidy. Did you want it open?
I just want to see.
Yeah, I'll put it open for you.
This is Trevor. Say hello to the camera.
Oh, hello. Yes, I'm sure I'm on it somewhere.
Trevor's a top man who's a... Are you the engineering manager at Corris?
Yeah, I look after the engine.
Top man.
You're like our local foreman, really, aren't you? Yeah. Trevor Trains, you called you, didn't they?
So it's all very
simple. Obviously, you've got your drain cocks, and that's very similar to three, just the handles look a bit different and what have you. What else is different on it, Chris?
Well, just looking outside, really. The brake block looks a different shape. You've cast your own, made your own brake block pattern.
Volunteers have done that for
there's
us.
There's a nice stop valve on the bottom of the clack valve. So the clack's on the bottom of the barrel, is it?
Yeah, so
the water goes in through the bottom of the
original locos always had the feeds through the bottom of the barrel.
I see.
Plane. when three was rebuilt in the mid to late 60s, they moved the feeds up to the top. But that was just to standardise like the rest of the TR engines.
This is how it was.
We thought, we put it back as it was? And we thought, well, actually, the cab's quite tidy at the moment. It would just clutter it if we put the top feeds in. So we left them where they were, and we'll see how they are. And if there's any issues, we can always change them. But I can't see there being any issues. Obviously, you probably noticed the whistle.
Number three,
obviously, it's still got its original dome cover. And it's still got its original hole, but unfortunately that's been blanked off now. New bits of boiler, that sort of thing.
That's a casting, that dome, isn't it?
It's a casting, yeah.
It's a steel, iron casting.
When I was 13, I had to carry that off a lorry up there and take it all the way down there.
I've done you any harm.
That's why I'm as strong as I am now.
Oh, kid it.
Yeah. So obviously we've got a nice little whistle there.
Yeah.
Looks like a Western one.
It works though, doesn't it?
But for you, it doesn't sound like one. obviously you've got your salt and safety valves as well.
Good.
This all looks quite tidy, really,
isn't it? It's cracking. It's really nice.
Obviously, we've got mechanical lubricator on it as well. A bit more modern, a bit more hassle-free.
Well, the beauty of those, you can actually see it feeding, can't you?
Yeah.
Through the back.
Yeah, this one's overfeeding at the moment, but while we're running it in, it's a week out the box, isn't it, really? Mm. So it's overfeeding a bit, but we can fine-tune it and tweak it. What else have we got? What have you spoke about this side?
It's coming, isn't it? Nice little holder for the air brake palm cup.
The holder, stop the hose banging about.
Yeah, we don't have that.
That's the unrebuilt type of air pump, isn't it? As we found out yesterday when we were swapping it round.
Yeah.
And we've made things as easy to access oiling-wise as we can. Obviously, we've copied these boxes off three. They're nice for the axle boxes, and you're not trying to avoid all the pipe work to get in there. You've got these little flippy up lid cups as well. You can just open them with a spout of the air. Your oil can.
Oh, your air fitting's in a different place, isn't it?
So if you want to put an air
supply for the blower in the mornings.
If the engine's cold, you plug it in.
Shader on it, that's good.
Yeah.
Ours, you have to screw in.
And the thing is, like the Talyllyn ones, if they wear, you've got to change a lot of the components. You can just change that valve on this, which is a bit future proof, really. But it's, you know, that's what I like about the alliance we've kind of got between here. And obviously, I'm on both railways, so having a bit of an alliance, it helps. And compare best practice, and
you've made some modifications, which is sensible, haven't you?
Yeah,
it's good.
Yeah,
really nice.
I never thought you'd say such a thing.
Well, I don't want your head to get too big.
Yeah.
So, Patrick, thank you so much for inviting us to this absolutely fantastic day, and it really has. It's been glorious sunshine, loads of people here, really exciting to see the engine, an absolute beautiful engine, it really is. And, you know, this has been so long in the making, and now it's finally here and finally running. You must be absolutely chuffed with that.
Oh, we are thrilled with the amount of, you know, the effort and the time taken to get here, the milestone of it running.
Yeah.
It's just unbelievable.
It is.
Unbelievable.
It's absolutely what people are going to be writing about
in history
books for years and years to come. But it doesn't stop,
no,
does
it? Doesn't.
It?
No.
What is next? Where are you going now?
I think it was very keen for us to identify that we had, after building the carriage shed, we had three main projects on the go. Corris Station, the Southern Extension, number 10.
Yeah.
And I've always set out to start narrowing those down, because criticism, fairly, is that we've been too stretched.
Yeah.
You know, we've had three big projects. So we've finished the station as far as we can for now.
Yep.
We do want to do a building.
Oh, yeah.
We can grant. We can apply for grant funding for that.
Oh, brilliant!
And
that really helps.
That will come, but we don't want to distract from the Southern Extension.
Yes.
So we're going to close the Corris Station as complete.
Yep.
This is complete.
Right. Absolutely.
And thankfully, for all the donations and all the people that have, you know, that have paid their money and continuing to pay their money, the bills are covered.
Fab.
So it's Southern Extension is our priority.
Oh, amazing. So, Southern Extension, that way, how far are you going?
About 3/4 of a mile.
Brilliant.
Down almost as far as Escargilliog, Evans Bridge.
Right,
you know.
Okay.
We're going to put a run-round loop in,
yep.
That's the plan. So, there's a culvert, we have to do a bridge.
Oh wow, okay.
We've got an embankment to build.
Oh gosh, so it's not a small project.
No, it's not.
Not at all.
But in real terms, it's not a very big bridge.
Yeah.
It's not a very long extension. Other railways have done it.
Oh, absolutely.
And well, I think we've proven we can do.
This is it. You can do massive projects and you've got the support and you've got the manpower and, you know, it's just strength to strength, isn't it? Because that's what's going to keep the visitors coming.
Yes.
And that's what keeps us here, isn't it? I mean, that's what, you know, something we work by as well as you guys. So it's something new to see.
We want the rail enthusiasts. We want the people to come along. But at the end of the day, it's the families, the children. Yep. They're the people that come along for their sort of, you know, morning out, afternoon out. And we want to offer more.
Absolutely. And they are also the future volunteers.
They are.
So when they come here and we're like, come on, help, you know. So, yeah, it's absolutely brilliant. And you're doing a fantastic job. So
I think we've got a great team.
Yeah.
It's a great group of people here. And it's collectively what we can do when we all work.
Together. Well, we work together, exactly. And obviously, we love working with you guys, and you're so close. And definitely, it's a joint effort. So, congratulations today.
No problem.
So, wow, it's been an absolute brilliant day seeing the newest steam locomotive
in the world.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it's great.
Running up and down. Full carriages of people. Absolutely. Everybody is so happy and enthusiastic about this project coming to its culmination. So, I think we need a cup of tea and a biscuit, don't we, Chris?
We will win. And how about an ice cream?
Yeah, ice cream. Oh, yeah, it's well hot. Should we go and get an ice cream?
Good
Should we jump on it?
Yeah, all right.
All right. Yep. Later.
Cheers, thanks a lot.